Welcome to ExcelBerry. In this video, you will learn all you need to know about a macro in Excel. What is it? How do you use it? And how do you take advantage of, for example, Record Macro, ChatGPT, and Google? And our mission is that we will try to make a macro that loops through all the different sheets that is not called Welcome Data or ExcelBerry.com. And then if we look here, we want to copy the data into the data sheet here. So that is our mission. So loop through all sheets except Welcome Data and ExcelBerry. And in each sheet, I want a macro to copy the range B3 to E7 and paste it into the last cell with values in column B in sheet data. And I want it also to paste the range as values, so we keep the format here. So that is our mission. Before we begin, we need the developer tab up here, because that's where we store all our macros. And if you don't have it, you just right click here in any of the tabs and press on customize the ribbon, and then make sure that the developer tab here is marked. And then you press on OK. And now you will have it. So here is all the tools for using macros. And a macro, if we go to the next section, is a programming instruction that automates a task or a series of tasks. So you write the code in what's called VBA, so that's the programmatic language, and it will do exactly what you've written from the top to the bottom. So here in the developer tab to the left, you have Visual Basic. So that's VBA. If you press on it, you will see all your opened Excel files and also a personal Excel file. That means that if you store a macro in the personal file, you will access the macro whenever you open an Excel file. But if you store it in an open file, you can only access the file if you have that file open. So it will be stored in that file and not on your computer. So that's the difference. So here, if we open this one, we will see all our sheets, and here we have modules. So it's in the modules that you write your code. So for example, here you can see a code for a macro. So in the beginning, you will have zero modules here, and to insert a new one, you go to the Insert tab and press on Module. So here is where we want to make our macro. And a macro always starts with sub, followed by the name of your macro. So that can be anything, but you can't use spaces. So let's say R sub R first macro. And we can use underlines here if we want to, and then go to the end and press enter. And you will have these parentheses, and it will end with end sub. So all that's in between these two lines is where we will write our macro. And it will do from the beginning to the end everything that we say that the macro should do. So that's the macro. And these pictures are connected to macros. So when I press on it, it will run a macro. So if I right click on it, I can assign a macro to any picture, and then I will have the names of all my macros and just assign one of the macros and press on OK. So then it will be assigned. And there are two very vital concepts when you work with macros. And the first one is variable, and the variable is a named storage location that holds a value or a reference to a value. And this value can be a number, a sequence of characters, an object, or a range of cell. So for example, in our mission, we wanted it to paste it in the last cell with values. So first it will copy the values from strawberry. That means B3 to perhaps E7. And the next time we paste it, we want it to be in B8. So we need a variable that changes all the time. So we don't hard code the reference B3, B7, B12, for example. We use a variable that's always changing. And to use a variable, you need to declare what kind of value you want it to be. And you do that by using a dim statement. So you dim counter as integer. So the word counter will after this line be a variable, and that variable should be integer. And integer is a value. So counter will now be a variable with a value. And we have integer and long. You will see integer and long as values. And after that, you can use the variable however you like. So that's the first concept that's great for you to know about. And the second one is loop. And the loop is a programming construct that allows you to repeat a block of code a certain number of times or until a certain condition is met. And there are different ways to use a loop, and I'd recommend for you to ask ChatGPT or Google for more information about that. But for example, here we wanted the macro to go through all the different cheats except data, welcome, and ExcelBerry. So we want to loop it. You start with the first cheat, do whatever you want to do, then you loop to the second cheat, to the third cheat, and so on. That's also a vital concept when you work with macros. So now it's time for us to start with writing our macro. There are different ways to do this. You can do it by yourself if you're really good. You can use the record macro. That's a built-in recording tool directly in Excel that records your mouse clicks and keystrokes. So in the developer tab, and then you find it here to the left, record macro, this box will appear. First, you name your macro. If you want to have it as a shortcut key to run the macro, then you tell Excel where you want to store your macro, if it's in the personal macro workbook or if you want to access it in this workbook only. Then you press on OK, and all our mouse clicks and keystrokes will now be recorded. And let's stop the recording, go to Visual Basic, find in Module 3 what was recorded. So it selects range D24. In the active cell, you write hello, and then you select D25. That's what we recorded with the tool record macro. You need to read all the lines to see if it behaves as you want it to behave. And when you use the record macro, there are some flaws with it. For example, if you filter values, you will automatically filter with equal sign. So you filter all values that you have marked and not equal to. So if you want to change that, you need to change in the code. So there are some flaws with record macro, but it's very easy to use. So I'd recommend for you to start there. Then we have Google. And almost everything I ever wanted to do with macros were only a Googling away. So you write VBA and then whatever you want to do. But the problem is that you need to break it down, because if you try to Google our entire mission, you will probably not find a very good result. So you need to break it down into multiple Googles. So for example, the first one should probably be VBA loop through all sheets except 3. And then you will change whatever comes up with welcome data and ExcelBerry. So for example, if we go here, VBA, Google, VBA, loop through all sheets except 3. Let's see, loop through all sheets except sheet 1. So, and you just pick one of the forums here and then you'll find your code, and then you can copy it into VBA. So that's also one way to do it. But from December 2022, I'd recommend for you to sign up to ChatGPT and use that instead. So that's an AI tool that's free for now, at least. And you ask the question and it will write the code for you. So when OpenAI released the ChatGPT for everyone to use, writing macros has never been so easy. We just copy our instructions, and we need to be very clear with our instructions. We can also add instructions afterwards, but let's copy this one here. Go to chat.openai.com, and here, write a macro in Excel, and then write our mission, and then press on go. So here it will think for a couple of seconds. It will explain what the macro does, each line, and how you use it. It's so easy, and we just copy the code up here, go to Excel, go to our file, go to the developer tab, Visual Basic, and instead of the code here, we paste our code from ChatGPT, and let's try to run it. And here you can see that it correctly copied and pasted exactly what we wanted it to do. And let's just have a look at the macro. So dim VS as worksheet, and that's also a variable. So you say that the VS, the letters VS, should be a variable, and the variable should be worksheet. And then for each, so you make a loop, and for each worksheet in this workbook worksheet. So you loop through every worksheet, and if the name is something else than welcome data and ExcelBerry, then you copy the range B3 to E7 and you paste it in cheat data into the last cell in the B column, and then you end the if statements, and then you go on to the next worksheet. So that worked perfectly, and it was customized to our need. So I'd recommend for you to use the ChatGPT, write clear instructions, and go through the lines before you run the macro. And some other tips I want to tell you before we end this video is that you cannot save an Excel file after you've run a macro. So make sure that you save your file before you run the macro. Also, there are different ways to run a macro. You have in the developer tab macros, and then you can run it from here. You can be in the VBA and stand with your mouse in a macro and then press on the green button up here, or you can assign it to an image or actually any illustration. So there's different ways to run your macro, and that's pretty much all I wanted to show you in this video. I hope you learned a lot. Please like the video if you learned something, subscribe to the account if you want to learn even more in Excel, and go my course on excelberry.com. Thank you.